Am I filming? Okay. Bonjour, guys, and welcome back to C'est Savoir Soap. So today I'm going to be attempting something that I'm pretty sure I am going to mess it up. But we're gonna try it anyway. I am going to be attempting the highly anticipated sea moss soap. So I'm gonna be making a co-processed soap today, which incorporates sea moss gel. You guys have all been asking for it, so today's a day where I'm gonna experiment with it. I'm gonna shower with it, let all my friends shower with it, and if it holds up, I'll sell it to you guys. If it doesn't, I'll keep trying, I don't know. Anyways, I have already prepped my oils, my lye solutions. I'm gonna take you guys on the journey with me. Just so you guys know, I do not make any claims to any of my soaps. I make claims to the ingredients within the soap. I believe that if you could put it in ya, you could put it on ya. That don't sound too right. But I do believe I stand firmly by turmeric, activated charcoal, sea moss. These things have so many good benefits. And if we could eat all of these things, I believe that we can put them on our skin and it could be nourishing to our skin. So, with any further ado, come watch me fuck this soap up. Okay, you guys, here we go. Attempt number one. All right, so we already have, like I said, I have my coconut oil, my olive oil, my avocado oil, my castor oil. Everything is in this bucket. Today we're gonna do a small batch. Well, I do a small batch every day, so I don't know why I'm capping. But first thing I'm gonna do, I'm going to incorporate my colloidal oats and my kaolin clay. I put that in all of my soaps. So since I am testing a batch, I wanna go with the stuff that I typically do. You know what I mean? I don't wanna put nothing new. Like, I wanna put coconut powder in this one, but I'm not, because I wanna make sure that I'm sticking to my recipe so that when I really have to make this batch for you guys, I know how this sea moss is gonna behave in my soap. All right, so let me just mix this stuff in. You guys could see better, but listen, sis don't got money for no camera yet, so y'all gonna get this good old iPhone 10. All right, so I'm just mixing this stuff in, making sure it incorporates while we move on to our other steps. All right, that should be good for now. I'm kind of nervous, y'all. I'm suited up, let me pull my sleeves down. I'm now gonna add my lye water solution into the oils, and then it's gonna move fast after that. So if I go quiet, I'm gonna throw on some music and just know I'm messing all this shit up. Okay, all right, y'all know the vibe. All right, okay, so I'm gonna do that a light trace. I'm not gonna over blend for now. I'm gonna mix until we get emulsion. I really wanted to say thank you to everyone who participated in my soft launch. I just wanted to see if I was able to ship my soaps effectively without messing it up, because hey, it's me, and I know myself. So I'm so grateful for everyone who purchased soap. If you guys have any questions about it, please follow me on Instagram at C'est Savoir Soaps. No, I lied. Take it back. Follow me at C'est Savoir on Instagram. DM me, ask me any questions you'd like. One thing I want to remind you guys is to definitely keep your soaps in a dry place. All right, don't say I ain't tell y'all. If you ain't using it, keep it in a dry place. All right, I'm gonna give it a little blend. All right, that's it. We ain't doing too much now. So So far, so good. I did not expect to get all of the love that I got from this soap launch. Like, you guys really showed up and you showed out, and I'm so grateful. I am so grateful. Oh, I didn't even tell y'all where I got my sea moss from. Stop playing. Okay, so I got my sea moss gel from St. Lucia. It's already incorporated with ginger in there. I will tell y'all, first let me find out if the supply is even still supplying, and then I'ma let y'all know. But for now, just know that this bad boy is straight out of St. Lucia. It is sea moss in there, and they soaked it to make the gel, and then they put ginger in it. So it's sea moss and ginger, okay? I have a whole bunch more, but that's just the one that I'm testing out for now. All right, so I think we're at emulsion, so I'm just gonna add my sea moss in there. I'm not putting a lot, cause y'all, well, technically this, for this little old batch, this is plenty. When I'm making for y'all, you know, I'ma beef it up a little bit, but for now, this is just for me. I wanna see how sea moss behaves in cold processed soap. This thing could volcano, this thing could overheat, this thing could do a whole lot of. So in order for me to know how it performs, I'm gonna try it out for myself. You feel me? So I'm just gonna go ahead and put that in there. Oh, baby. Now you guys know all the benefits of sea moss. I feel like I don't even gotta tell y'all. And if I do, I don't know how to put it in the description, but I'll let you know. But did you know that sea moss, and correct me if I'm wrong, has 92 out of the 110 minerals that our body needs? I believe it's 92 minerals out of 100 or 110. Comment below and let me know which one is it. Is it 110 or 100? So this is technically a superfood. So with all that goodness in there, I know during the pandemic, everybody was eating sea moss galore. Well, drinking it, eating it, whatever y'all do. Let me mix it up a little and make sure it's all the way incorporated. Then I'll add my fragrance. And we done, baby. Because I ain't putting nothing else crazy in here. Oh. She thickening up, y'all. All right, before she get crazy, I'm gonna add my fragrance oil. This is one of my favorites, so I'm, of course I'll be saving it for my soaps. It's a nice little blend. It smells like green tea with a hint of citrus. Let me just make sure I get all of it out, cause y'all know El Cheapo over here, I don't be playing those kinds of games. I don't know where y'all get y'all money from, but I sit at a 9-to-5 and deal with crazy kids for my money. So I'm gonna make sure it counts. Okay, get every last drop in that bad boy. And we're just gonna stir. You guys. Okay, it's not hot. Well, it's not overheating. I don't know if you could see this. I'm not gonna color it either. I wanna see what the natural color of the sea moss. I wanna just see what it's gonna do to the soap. So I'm not putting no other colorants, just my normal additives, which is kaolin clay, colloidal oats, my fragrance oil, and sea moss. That way I will know how it truly performs. If I put some random stuff in here and then act crazy, how would I know if it's a sea moss? Or how would I know if it's the other stuff? But I know my other additives works well in all my soaps, so I'm not even tripping. Ooh, it looks good and it smells good. This is not speeding up trace. It's not accelerating. It's not turning no funky colors. You guys, I think I done did some shit. Is it, baby? I can't wait to shower with this. It smells fresh, like not not fishy fresh, but like, it smells like a nice green garden, like green tea and leaves and bay leaves. And I'm taking it back to Castries. I'm taking it back to the Lucia, baby. With this smell, every time I take this smell, it reminds me, I feel like I'm sitting under a mango tree with a bucket of water and a bucket of mangoes. And I'm just, y'all know the vibe. Y'all know the vibe. This looks so good. I don't even want to stop. All right, you guys, it is officially time for the pour. When I tell you this soap is giving me life, I really enjoyed making it. It's giving me under the guava tree, under the mango tree, under the hot damn picking breadfruit. It's giving me all of the shits, all of the St. Lucian vibes. And I'm just ready to shower with it. It smells amazing and I know it's gonna do great things for my skin. Look at that, y'all. Come on, somebody. Say amen. Come on, somebody. I'm gonna tap to get all the air bubbles out. Y'all know I'm not leaving this in no pot. So I am going to scrape every single piece of soap out of here. Cause I'm not playing with my coins. I'm not playing with y'all coins. You guys, I'm not, come here y'all. I'm not even gonna attempt to texture the shit on camera. Cause y'all know how that goes. Okay, so I'm gonna make this pretty. It's gonna take me some time. I'm gonna make this pretty and I'm gonna come back for the cut. So I will see you guys in 18 to 24 hours when it's time to cut this bad boy. And then I gotta wait 4 weeks to use it and then tell y'all how good it is. If you have made it this far in the video, it's for one of two reasons. Either you like me and soap making or you minding my business. So I'ma just say you like me and you like watching me make soap. So just hit the subscribe button, hit that like, hit the bell notification, and comment below what other things you guys want me to either succeed or fail at. Tell me what y'all want me to try. But I think this is a hit. This is a bop. I made it. We did it. This is it. Okay? So hit the comments with some, say something. Comment, like, subscribe. That's what they be saying, right? Comment, like, subscribe. And I will see you guys back for the cut. Deuces. You guys, I done did some shit. Look how beautiful this sea moss and ginger soap looks. I'm tempted to call her coronavirus. But I won't. But look how gorgeous this loaf of soap came out. So I'm gonna have her sit for 18 to 24 hours and then we will be back for the cut. I'm telling you, I'm gonna go to bed sleeping and I'm gonna be thinking about this soap. This is all I'm gonna be thinking about while I'm sleeping. So here you have it, guys. Sea moss and ginger. She smells phenomenal. And I can't wait to make you guys your very own. All right, see you guys back for the cut. Deuces. All right, you guys, so we are back for the cutting and the stamping of the sea moss soap. I'm really excited about it. The only thing I've noticed is the soap is pretty soft, but that just could be because I've had it sitting in the mold for some time. Let's see. So it's not going to be anything pretty to look at. Like I said, it's just regular sea moss soap. I'm just excited to use it. If I could use it today, I would. And I'm cutting these bars a little bit bigger because they're for me. If it works out well, I'm going to save you guys some, but these are definitely for me. What I realize, looking at this, I can tell that it is soft because it never went through gel phase. So it didn't get hot enough, which is a good thing. I ain't tripping. It is a good thing. I'm just gonna have it sit and cure while it evaporates some of this water out of it. And then we'll take it from there. And I can't believe it's been this long, so long. And I still linger over you. Still linger over you. My people told me to be through with you, darling. But that ain't what I wanna do until I hear from you. So I'm hoping there could one day be a chance. A chance. For me to hold you. Let me hold you, babe. Oh, I don't want to fade away. If you walk out that door, girl, I'll never get another chance. Oh, let me hold you, darling. Oh, don't let it fade away. Don't let me get another chance.
Sent you my open scribe. To my surprise, you never replied, but I never realized the pain that you hide inside is blind to the eyes. For that, I apologize. You notice, you should have been my only focus. Wasn't my top priority, but was the closest. It's like when one door opens, another closes. If I can do it again, I would have never chose this. 2 dozen roses. I left him with the dough, man. I saw the letters that I wrote there that you ain't ever opened. Now listen, I just wrote to say I'm sorry and I'm a different man. I ain't trying to ruin none of your future plans, girl, but I still ain't get over you. Your mama told me that you're through with me, dog. But I won't take that for the truth till I hear that from you. So I'm hoping there could one day be a chance.
You guys, it's done. Thank you so much for watching. I will catch you guys on the next one.